Ypsilanti has a lot of strengths. We have a very strong sense of community here.
And if you know anything about Willow Run, you know we have a strong family commitment.
We also have a very strong sense of self-determination.
I think nothing defines a community more than its school district.
Both districts were drowning. The debt was rising in both districts while academic achievement was declining.
And sooner or later, financial manager was gonna come in.
Nobody wanted an outside emergency manager to come in and make decisions for us about our kids.
When our backs are against the wall in Ypsilanti, when things get tough, when people say it can't be done, we roll up our sleeves and figure out a way to get it done.
Out of that, you know, came this idea that it might be better for all of us if we were working with the Willow Run schools instead of trying to find a way to compete with them.
And the view was that together these districts would be much stronger than they were separately.
As a whole, you have the opportunity to become more focused and more determined to be a successful district for everybody involved, teachers, staff, students.
So once we had that one common goal, things started coming into place.
So in March of 2012, the recommendation from the subcommittee was that the boards put the question of consolidation on the ballot.
61% of voters in both districts approved this consolidation.
Consolidation represented an opportunity to actually hit the reset button, to really build the new school system from the ground up.
It gives the community an opportunity to make this what they want it to be.
The parents and the people in the community had a direct impact in terms of what they're going to, the quality of education and the type of education they were going to provide to the students in this district.
This is the community school district, right? It's the Ypsi area community school district.
We were really encouraged to think outside of the box, really think for a long-term vision. What should this school district look like?
They took a wide range of meetings, public forums, involving the stakeholders.
It had students at the table, it had parents at the table.
Leaders in the community, there were people from the universities.
People like myself who don't even have kids in the district yet. And everybody's voice was equally heard.
It was a really collaborative process. And then from there, that committee began to kind of put together final recommendations.
And the community identified five core pillars, things that were essential elements of the new school district. The first was a focus on prenatal through kindergarten entry. Another pillar is effective leadership at all levels. Then the third is a culture and climate focused on learning. Another pillar is high quality teachers and teaching. And then the final piece is that we want every student to graduate with college credit or career credential.
And I think throughout the planning process, the advisory committees and the school board really focused in on those five pillars.
My concern, of course, from the beginning was all of these ideas, are they going to remain in the end? But they were really true to that, and we were able to really make sure that our voices were heard from beginning to end.
It's a school that by design is reaching out to all of our community.
It made sense in terms of creating more efficiency so that we can reach far more students with a broader impact.
The new district is going to provide, of course, some new resources. Definitely pushing a more innovative curriculum, more innovative instruction.
Then the system itself will be small learning communities, which is an ability for students to focus in and learn on their time.
I'm most excited about the whole cradle to career approach,
which means, you know, pre-K through 20. So it'll be post-secondary, meaning that when our students graduate, they'll have an opportunity to have a diploma in one hand, and on the other hand, they can have an associate's degree from a community college, or it can be a career credential. And that alone is going to stand out in Washtenaw County.
We're offering something that no other district, no other school in Michigan can offer.
This unification really awakened everyone in the community. Now we're looking at education in a different way.
Every classroom will be staffed with a highly qualified and effective teacher.
And one of the goals is really to give every student the opportunity to have college experience while they're part of the Ypsilanti Community Schools District.
I'm very hopeful that these students will leave the Ypsilanti Community Schools with a lot to offer our larger community.
We are constantly going to be evolving to meet the needs of the students and the members of the community.
I really believe by investing in education, this whole community investment, we're going to produce really productive citizens that are going to come back and contribute to the community.
Kind of leading by example, if we show that we are having a positive attitude, hopefully it'll brush off and it'll spread kind of. I mean, we impact more each other more than we really realize.
We will be an amazing school district with amazing students, amazing staff, and an amazing history that will follow behind our name.
Ypsilanti Community Schools was good because Willow Run's really like a community. And honestly, we are in Ypsilanti.
And there's such a rich heritage and a sense of pride and community and culture and heritage here that everybody came together and really wanted the best for our students.
This is our district. This is what we want it to look like. This is what we wanted to kind of symbolize for the community.
Because if our schools are strong, our community is going to be strong.
We think our kids deserve the very best education they can get anywhere, and they're going to get it right here in Ypsilanti.